All right. Well, this hand's kind of speculative because we do have a think twice and a blue source, and we're on the draw. And we have like dispel and a negate. So if we draw a land, I mean, we need to draw like two lands, but we do have a think twice. I'm gonna mulligan. We have 24 lands. Draw a land. Yeah, I'm gonna mulligan. Yeah. The thing is, in this matchup, I'd rather keep a hand with like six lands and one spell than one land and six spells, just because the games go long and you just don't want to miss land drops. So I kind of just wanted to mulligan there to try to just have an opening hand with more lands. Although think twice is very nice in the matchup. There's no real instant that I think he can possibly play, so I'm going to just dot scour myself here. And then, okay, yeah, play a Sulphur Falls. Thought scour myself to try to hit some think twices, and also, you know, I know his win condition is to mail me out, but it's nice just to, at least in the beginning, have some number of cheap possible instants that I can get out there. All right, so he's got a couple think twices in there. We don't have a negate, so yeah, might as well just play an Augur of Bolas. Hit? All right. We'll take it. All right. Well, we do have a Dissipate here, and I'm not exactly sure what kind of Planeswalkers he can play, so I want to keep up Dissipate, but yeah, definitely we're going to be drawing some cards this turn. Yeah, I'm just going to Thought Scour him. Got a Snapcaster and a Dissipate. All right, those are some good spells. Land? Yes. All right, so I'm just going to take two. That way we have mana for Dissipate and Dispel. You know, I don't know how many copies of like I don't know how many copies of Snapcaster Day Pelea, but I don't think it's too many. All right, so his plan is to mill me out. The question is, do I want to cast a Restoration Angel now? Probably not. It resolves, but he can just Wrath me out. I think I'm still just going to run it out. If he has a counterspell, then he won't be able to Drownyard me this turn. And we have a bunch of cards in our hand. Okay, it resolved, which is cool. Yeah, I'll take a Dissipate. Think twice is nice to smooth out our draws, but having just hard counter seems better. Boom. All right, so he's on the Drown Me plan. He probably has a Supreme Verdict. I'm assuming? Yeah, he definitely has a Supreme Verdict. All right. So now we're just going to drop Snapcaster Mage just to... you know, just put on some pressure. That's the best thing to do, I think. Let's just get a Thought Scour. Thought Scour him. Just to draw a card. That way we can Thought Scour and cast the Azorius Charm in our hand. We just don't want to miss land drops, and we just want a million counterspells, so. Ooh, Devour Flesh. All right. Wish we had a Jace to make him pay here, but we do not. All right, well, our hand is kind of loaded, but if he's just Drown Yarding us every turn, we can't do much. Yep. I don't want to discard last turn, so I'm just going to try to cast the big revelation here. Just try to draw a counterspell so that our counterspells are better later. Oh, he's got his own. Yeah, that could have that was probably a misplay. Like, I could have. Like, he drew five. Well, I mean, he still has a discard too. But could have just left up one, I guess. All right. We're going to have to discard a bunch of cards. Like, I could just play an Angel to not have to discard. Because, like, I can discard Azorius Charm, and I don't know if I want to discard Hallowed Fountain. No, it's still probably better. Like, I want to keep all these cheap counterspells, and I like the Angel, and I like the Snapcaster Mage, and I like the Sphinx's Revelation, so. Yeah, that's fine. Alternatively, I could have discarded the Sphinx's Revelation. Let's see. Which one do I want to cast? Do I just run out an Angel? Sure. Nice. Easily take two damage. All right, well, our hand is pretty nice. But we're just basically at this point racing each other. He's trying to mill me out while I'm trying to kill him with the Angel. So we'll see how it goes. Basically, I have to avoid some number of Wrath of Gods. I think I'm going to cast Snapcaster Mage here. Like I said, just to put on some additional pressure. Let's see, what do I want to do? Do I want to... maybe I just want to Revelation for two? Yeah, that seems okay. This time I'm going to leave up a Dispel. Ooh, does he have a negate too? That would suck. All right, well, he just let it resolve. That's cool. Yeah, so he obviously has another revelation. There's no reason for him to play a revelation there just because he has a handful of cards. All right, so we do have a Boris Reckoner here, so hopefully we can draw like a Harvest Pyre. And once again, there's a Harvest Pyre. Let's see how many Snapcasters did he hit. One, two. All right, so there's still one Snapcaster left in our deck. So he wants a Revelation. Let's just dissipate that, just because it's a more expensive counterspell, I think. Yeah. We can still dissipate with double dispel or double dissipate. That's unfortunate. Yep. Can't do much about that. All right, I'm gonna just Revelation again to try to hit something big. At this point, yeah, I'm just gonna go the full three. And if he casts a Sphinx's Revelation, that's okay. All right, okay, so this is actually that was a good draw. So now that we have Jace with all these dispels, like we're actually pretty close to just killing him. So, yeah, I'm going to play a Glacial Fortress and then just play a Jace. And then we still have Plan B here. But I feel like Jace is the better plan here. Mill you for 10. So there's definitely going to be some kind of a counter war, I'm assuming. All right. Boom, Tenya. All right, so there's a couple of rest in pieces, negate, think twice, okay, whatever. All right. So this is the pretty cool thing, like, you know, he might have to try to spend a lot of resources to kill the Jace next turn, which will, choke him on his mana. And then, we can still kill him with Boros Reckoner, Snapcaster Mage, Harvest Pyre. So let's see what he's going to do here. I don't know if he kept in Detention Sphere for the matchup. Maybe he did. But things are looking pretty decent, I would say. Like, we have all these counter spells plus a secondary win condition here. All right, so dissipate. Leave up two blue. Dispel this. And dispel this. And F6, because we can't do anything else. Oh, his own Jace. All right, nice. Now we use we even drew the Jace here. But now we can just basically just kill him. Red, white, white. I don't know why. Just take two, why not? Snapcaster Mage. We got the Harvest Pyre in here, right? Yeah. And dead. Unless there's a Slaughter Pact in the format I do not know about. Seven, eight, nine. All right. And that is round one. So yeah, that was a pretty interesting match. Like, the control mirror Jace definitely put some extra pressure on him, and we were able to get him with the Boros Reckoner Harvest Pyre combo. On to round two. Although, also, I don't think Rest in Peace is that great of a sideboard card against this deck. Like, he has his own thing twices, like, and he also has his own Snapcaster Mage. So basically, he's just losing out on a card here when it hurts us pretty much equally. So I would not bring in Rest in Peace if I was Esper, but everything else seems reasonable.